Hello dear all, hope that you all are fine. In our previous lecture we discussed about the samprapti, and in that context we discussed about the definition of samprapti and its synonyms. Now we will discuss about general samprapti and specific stages of samprapti, or someone says that it's they are the types of samprapti too. So in this today's class we will discuss about these two topics, general samprapti and visishta samprapti. And now general samprapti, and six stages of kriya kal is known as samanya samprapti. And now you are well aware of that there are six stages of development of disease, and they are known as kriya kal. That is sanchayam cha prakopam cha prasaram asthan sensram vyaktim bhedam cha yo vetti doshana. These are the six stages of samprapti, and they are included in the samanya samprapti. So we will discuss in very short, because you all are well aware of these six stages. Now only one thing I will tell here. In the stage of sanchay, there is accumulation of particular dosha. In fact, if we can see that which dosha is getting accumulated, or either one or two or more than one dosha is being vitiated, so actually there is collection of there is sanchay of particular guna of that dosha. Sanchay actually refers that particular good is vitiated and it is getting accumulated so that it can cause some kind of disease. This is a very important thing that Acharya Charak have already said, that ruksh laghu shit darun khar vishad susir karani sariranam tatha videshu sarireshu vayur asrayam गत्वा आप्यमान प्रकोपम आपद्यते. इट इज अ रेफरेंस ऑफ चरक सूत्र स्थान चैप्टर 12. मोस्ट लाइकली आई एम अनेबल टू, इट इज मोस्टली मोस्ट लाइकली इट इज चरक सूत्र स्थान चैप्टर्स 12. दैट ही वेरी क्लियरली ही सेज दैट इफ देयर इज फ्रीक्वेंट एक्सपोजर ऑफ रूक्ष लघु शीत डाइट, देन it causes vitiation of ruksh laghu and sheet gud of vat. So since such kind of food, if exposed for prolonged time, or if it is taken in inappropriate manner, they causes some degree of vitiation of that particular thing. If you are taking sheet ahar, either in the form of sheet beer or in the form of sheet aspers, so that will vitiate sheet gud of vat, or that may vitiate the kapha. That depends on the other coexisting factors. So there are so many examples. Trump what says that ratri jagran increases kapha, and diva jagran increases vat. So there is vitiation that causes abnormal accumulation of particular type good of that particular dose, and when they get vitiated in sufficient amount, and there is they try to come out from that lower their own place, because sanchay is vriddhi swadhamanyo. So sanchay is vriddhi swadhamanyo, it gets accumulated on its own place, where if there is vitiation at particular site of vat, pakva dhan gudanale, so there is a specific place, and on that specific place at the vitiation of vat, which particular type of vat is happens, and that leads to prakop in further. So here you will show there are two type of symptoms in the stage of sanchaya, and there is one symptom which is caused by the particular dose as which appears directly, and there is some other kind of symptom also, that there is general symptom which refers chaya karan videshas cheti, na, what says that there is chaya karan videsh. What Acharya Vaghbhat add further in it, that Bipreet Gudekcha cha. He does not likes to take that factor which is causing accumulation of that particular guru. Instead, he prefers such kind of diet or habit or habitat which can normalize the vitiation of those. So this is general principle, that it likes and there is dislike of favorable or unfavorable thing in the stage of sanjaya. This is the general symptom of sanjaya avastha. Then there are some specific symptoms of sanjaya, that is dattatra sanchita nam khal dosa nam astabd purna kosta pita uvasta mandoshmata changa nam gauram alashyam. These are the symptoms that is manifested by vitiation of particular dosa. So what says that accumulation leads to some degree of vitiation of dosa, and these symptoms are only due to vitiated dosa. There is these are not symptoms of any disease. So these are the, just say that there is astabd purna kosta, and then pita bhasta, lowest discoloration of body, and mandoshmata, there is mandagni, and anganam gauram, there is heaviness in the body, and alasya, there is lethargyness. These are the symptoms of sanchaya avastha. So there are three things in the stage of sanchaya. There in sanchaya there is accumulation of particular type of guna, either one or more than one of that vitiated dosa, and there is two type of symptom. One is a general symptom, that is chaya karan videshasch and vipreet gudekcha cha. Na, to you, if you will see that there is pitt vriddhi lakshana sheet kamta, that causes sheet kamta, na, to that is vipreet gudekcha cha, that it has desire for that opposite symptom. Then there is prakopastu unmargamita, tends to move from its own place, that is the stage of prakop, and it also have some kind of symptom as tesham prakopat kostut sancharan amlika pipasa parida annadvesh hridayot kledasch jayante. There is no any specific general symptom. Instead, since initially there was some symptom in the stage of sanchaya by vitiated dosa, so along with that symptom, some more symptoms are added to in this stage, that is kosht-tod sancharan. See the difference, that in the stage of sanchaya there was astabd-purna kosta, there was some kind of stagnancy, and in the stage of prakop, they try to move from their own place, so they causes kosht-tod sancharan. And it sancharan is begins from this stage, and then proper sancharan takes place in the phase of prashar, which is called as gatiya. It's movement from its own place, so it comes out from its own place and moves throughout the body and causes some kind of symptoms in this stage too. And now here it is very clear that in this stage specific symptoms appear as vayur bimar gamnam atopo. That say that there was astabd purna kosta in initial stage, there was a stagnancy, then it was trying to come out, so say that kost tod sancharan. And now see in the stage of prashar, it shows vayur bimar gamnam atopo, there is clear cut indication that in these three stages there is clear cut demarcation about the three stages of what. Accordingly, symptoms of pith also appears in different stages. And initially there was yellowish discoloration, but coming up to this stage, there is osh, chosh, paridah, dhumaya, nani, and this such kind of a symptom that there is appears in the stage of prashar. So these symptoms are due to particular dosh, because there is no any dosh to samurchana up to that. So that all the symptoms which are produced in this three stages are only due to the particular dosh. And after prashar there is yatra sang khave gunyat vyadhis tatra upajayate na prakupita naam hi dosha naam sharire paridhavatam yatra sang khave gunyat vyadhis tatra upajayate. To they moves throughout the body, and where they found their favorable place they get localized. So in nidan it must be remembered that nidan causes vashiyeshan of three factors. One is dosh, other is dosh, and third is srotas. And you can see there in the context of sroto dushti karan that there is aharas viharas ya shat dosh gula shama dhatur bhi bigulas chapi means, and srotsam sa produska focus on two things, that it causes dhatur bhi bigulas chapi and it also causes srotsam sa produska. So these two factors are important, means along with vaishyeshan of dosh they causes vaishyeshan of dosh as well as vaishyeshan of srotas too. So we discussed in our previous slide that we take example of one common thing, that mycobacterium tuberculi, that it circulates throughout the body via blood, and where it gets through air, and when it gets its favorable place, either if gets in favorable place in lung it causes pulmonary tuberculosis, if it goes to the abdomen is it causes abdominal tuberculosis, and if it goes to bones then it causes bone tuberculosis. So all of them have different symptom depending on the contact of particular dosh, that which organ or which part is vitiated and which is which get infected. The same bacterium causes different kind of symptom according to the dosh. So what he says that when it gets favorable place then it causes disease, if it does not gets favorable place it can't lead to any disease. And here there is asthan sansray, though there is appearance of poor roop asthan sansriya ku ansa asthan sansriya kruddha bhavi vradhi prabodhakam dosha kurvanti yad lingam poor roopam taduchite, means since there is dosh sammurchana takes place, so just before those two sampushna they leads to some kind of symptom which is known as poor roop, and when those two sammurchana completes then it leads to any particular disease, those two sammurchana janto juradi roopu vyadhi. So when those two sammurchana is complete then it leads to a specific disease, symptoms of a specific disease, and before that it causes poor roop of that disease, and if not treated then it causes some kind of complications that are known as upadrav. And now different types are different stages of samprapti. There are actually they represent a specific samprapti, that which samprapti is being considered at that time. And when we go to see that which good is vitiated then we consider different kind of samprapti, and when we go for counting of different diseases we go for a different kind of samprapti, we say that it's different type of samprapti. And when we refers to particular guna then we say that there is different kind of samprapti. When we say that how many symptoms of that disease appeared at which stage, then we consider about different स्टेजेस ऑफ संप्राप्ति, डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ संप्राप्ति. सो इन दैट कंटेस्ट आवर फर्स्ट संप्राप्ति इज संख्या संप्राप्ति, एंड संख्या मीन्स जस्ट काउंटिंग, है ना, नथिंग यू हैव टू थिंक, इट्स काउंटिंग. संख्या स्याद गणितम, है ना, वेन वी काउंट समथिंग इन नंबर्स दैट इज नोन एज संख्या संप्राप्ति, है ना. हियर आर सम एग्जाम्पल्स, वी विल डिस्कस विद दीज एग्जाम्पल्स ओनली. That when we say that there is astrojora, there are eight types of jora, this is just counting. It's we are not saying which, what are these eight types. We just saying that this is eight types. So that is sankhya samprapti. When we say that there is panch gulma, when say that shad vidam tam vadanti, that is we have. See that it is for adhisar, yeah, we say panch kasa smrita, then it is for kas. So when we count different things at a time, that is known as sankhya samprapti. See that the basic thing is we are counting different thing at a time. I mean, just say that there are 29 scholars in PG department in Chaudhary Brahm Prakash. So we are just counting that there are 6 scholars in this department, this 5 scholars in this department, there are 6 scholars in this department. So we are just counting that we have. So we are counting that 5 discipline had different number of students. So since we are saying that these are the numbers of this department, so we are saying that they are differentiated between different things, the different disciplines. And a rog nidan is different discipline, kaya chikitsa is different discipline, sharir kriya is different discipline. So when we consider counting of different disciplines, that is known as sankhya samprapti. And if there is very close relation of sankhya samprapti with vidhi samprapti, so we will see now that what is a vidhi samprapti. Now since sankhya samprapti is just counting of different thing, and when we made some kind of internal classification, that is known as vidhi samprapti. When there is differentiation between two things, that is known as sankhya samprapti. And when there is differentiation of one thing, that is known as vidhi samprapti. What we have said that there is sankhyatu bhed matra hiti, but Nyaya Darshan says sankhyatu bhed matra, it is just a kind of counting of different thing. So what is vidhi? Samanen dharmed parigroho bhedanam, samanen dharmed parigroho means when saman dharm things of same nature is classified. Just say that when we consider about any particular discipline, that A, B, C, D, E are the students of this discipline. A, B, C, D, E are students of this discipline. So we are classifying that discipline. And we are not classifying different discipline. We are classifying single discipline. So that is known as vidhi samprapti. When we define a different kind of discipline, so that is known as sankhya samprapti. And when we further classify the same kind of discipline, that is known as vidhi samprapti. I am just taking example of jara, and we discussed in previous that there is astro jara, and the jara is 8 type, gulm is 5 type. So that was the classification between two things. Gulm is different thing and jora is different thing. And when we come to single thing, that jora has two types depending on the sharir and manas, and it is of two type. When we say that jora is of two type, antar vego vahir vego devidaya punar uchyate, since so we are defining jora on different types, and there are eight types of jora on the basis of आश्रय भेदेन सप्त विद्य वत्सत पुनर्देवदो दृष्टः सौम्य आग्नेश सौम्यश्च आग्नेयो च एंड दैट सम सौम्य एंड आग्नेय तो व्हाई वी आर डिफाइनिंग विधि संप्राप्ति बिकॉज अंतर्वेग जोर विल टेक्स डिफरेंट लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट बहिर्वेग जोर विज रिक्वायर डिफरेंट लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट सो वी आर डिफाइनिंग दैट when we say that there are eight types of jor, that is vatas, pittas, kaphas, sannipathas and so on. So each of these requires different line of treatment. So we are further categorizing that number depending on their specific feature, that is known as vidhi samprapti. See in the case of jor, tamahur vyadhi ghoram tam shadvidam badanti, there was only six in number. When we are saying that that is six in number, and in next line you can see that in the pathogenesis described by Acharya Madhav and Acharya Susruta, he shows that ek ek se sarvasas chapi dosah so ke nan shastra amin chaukta. Now you will see that there are ek ek se means either vat pit kapha sarvasas chapi means sannipata of that and sokaj and amas. So all of these six require different line of treatment, so they require different type of consideration. And when we define it on the basis of types of particular dose, that is known as vidhi samprapti. Or when we define dose kal bala balat, say in the reference of jor itself, you can just remember, try to remember that what Acharya says, puna panchvidha पंच विदो दृष्टो दोष काल बला बलात् है ना ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बल एंड अबल ऑफ दोष देयर आर फोर फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ ज्वर दैट इज संतत सतत सत्ता संततो अन्यो दुष्क तृतीय चतुर्थ को तो वी आर डिफाइनिंग ज्वर इटसेल्फ ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बला बलात् ऑफ व्हिच थिंग दोष सो दीज आर द major factor that when we are requiring internal classification to adopt some kind of treatment, so this is known as vidhi samprapti. And say then we have seen that there is, when just we classified that this is sankhya samprapti, it is just five, and when we further categorized it into a specific type of disease, with that it is vatas, pittas or antarveg, vihirveg, shakhasrit, kosht shakhasrit, depending on that nature. When we say that there is amatisar, pakvatisar, because both of these requires different line of treatment, so when we requires consider about different line of treatment, then we apply vidhi samprapti. And when we further categorize particular dose into particular good, that is known as vikalp samprapti. Now what sankhya means, whole total number, its internal classification is known as vidhi samprapti. And when there is further pinpoint consideration that this particular good is vitiated, that is known as vikalp samprapti. What says that doshanam samvetanam vikalpo ansansh kalpana, I mean there is vitiation of particular dose, there is equilibrium of that particular vitiated dose. Samvetanam is, there is, if they are collectively vitiated, to which part is vitiated? Vikalpo ansans. Ans here refers the good of that particular thing. So we are taking just one example. We discussed in the context of Atisar that when we say ghoram shadvidam tam badanti, then it is sankhya samprapti. When we say that ek eksa sarvasas chapi, this refers to vidhi samprapti. And when we go for what is happening in the pathogenesis of vataj atisar or pittaj atisar, see here that tat prakritam द्रवत्वात, उष्माणम उपहत्य, वत आचार्य चरक से, इट इज द लाइन फ्रॉम चरक संहिता, द द्रवत्वाद उष्माणम उपहत्य, है ना, इट काजेस वाइशिएशन ऑफ अग्नि, अग्निमान, इट काजेस वाइशिएशन ऑफ अग्निमान ड्यू टू द द्रवत्व गुण ऑफ अग्नि, है ना, तो सी दैट वी आर थिंकिंग दैट इट इज सिंपली काजिंग वाइशिएशन ऑफ द्रवत्व, है ना, अदर थिंग्स वी विल कंसीडर लेटर ऑन अप दैट विच कलर इज प्रोड्यूस्ड, विच द इनिशियल थिंग इज दैट इनिशियली इट इज काजिंग वाइशिएशन ऑफ द्रवत्व गुण दैट इज लीडिंग अग्निमान, एंड वेन इट्स कलर इज वाइशिएटेड देन इट काजेस वाइशिएशन इन कलर ऑफ स्टूल, वेन इट काजेस अम्ल वाइशिएशन ऑफ अम्ल गुण देन इट काजेस अम्लोद्गार, वेन इट काजेस वाइशिएशन इन उष्ण गुण देन इट काजेस सम काइंड ऑफ दाह एट दैट प्लेस. So when we are considering that this property of particular dose is vitiated, that is known as vikalp samprapti. Now what says that if we are exposed, someone is exposed to ruksha padartha, then rukshatva of vat will increase. And that not only, there is some habits too, then we are adhugaman. Now if he is walking for longer time, that what causes vitiation of chalgur. And there are so many things we can say here, that if there is exposure to particular habit or particular habitat or particular diet, that causes vitiation in particular gur of that dosh primarily, which is mainly responsible for production of that disease. And later on, when others good of that dose gets vitiated, they produce some specific symptom related with that disease. Now we there are number of examples you during PG you must be learned it, that kalaya causes vitiation of all properties of vat dosh, and chaulai causes vitiation of Shet, Roksh and Lagugud, most likely you can remember it. You know that it causes vitiation of Shet, Roksh and Lagu, because Cholai mainly have the Ruksh, Lagu and Sheetgud. Now there are so many examples that Madhur Rash causes vitiation of all the properties of Kapha Dosh, and Katuras in the same way for Pith. You know, there is Madh, which causes vitiation of all properties of Pitt dosa. When we say that all the properties of Vat dosa means Tatra Rukshu Laghu Sita Sushma Chalo Anila, means all of these are vitiated, and at a time, and in a contest of Atsar, we are looking here that initially Dravat is vitiated, because if there is not Dravat, vitiation of Dravat, then Agnimand will be not caused. And then if Agnimand will be not caused, then what will happen? Ki Apam Dhatu will be not get vitiated. So that is major important thing, that which is primarily vitiated and which are later on vitiated. That also causes origin of that particular disease. Say that in any contest, if there is vitiation of Ushna Guna initially, then Da will be produced. If there is vitiation of Aml Guna primarily, that will lead to Aml Pith. So, in the same contest, what we have also seen, that if Dravat is not causing Agnimand, and it is vitiating the Rakt Dosh, then what it leads to? It leads to Rakt Pith. Tad Dravyar Bhinnam Sangato Sneha Mrittagatam. Yeah, what says that? Tasya Ushma Dravyar Dhatur Dhatur Prasichyate. Means if that Dravatungur causes vitiation of Agni, it may lead to different kind of disease. And if that Dravat causes vitiation of something different like Rakt Dosh, then it causes रक्त पित्त. सो अलॉन्ग विद दैट प्राइमरी डोज देयर इज इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ डोज 2. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर इन द कंटेस्ट ऑफ अस्थान संशय कि इफ इट गेट्स लोकलाइज्ड इन द ब्लड समान यौनित्वात तद यौनित्वात प्रपन्नम वर्तते तत् प्रदोषयोत, तो इट काजेस रक्त पित्त. एंड इफ इट गोज टू अग्निमान इन पक्वाशय और समथिंग लाइक दैट अपान धातु, इट काजेस अतिसार. एंड व्हेन इट उष्मणत्व ऑफ पित्त इज वॉशिएटेड देन इट एंड इट इफ इट लोकलाइज्ड इन आमाशय इज वॉश spread throughout the body, then it causes jwar. So these are the factors that which primary good is vitiated and which dosh is vitiated. Both of these leads to origin of a specific kind of disease. So we discussed this samprapti vidhi samprapti, that if particular dosh is vitiated, you know, to which property of that vitiated dose is abnormal, that defines vidhi samprapti. But when we see that there are more than one dose in the stage of sansarg or sannipat, if there are more one dose, there is coexistence of vitiation of more than one dose, so we in that case we refer apradhanya samprapti. स्वतंत्र स्वतंत्रतया पारतंत्रभ्याम व्याधे प्राधान्यम आदिशे दैट व्हिच इज प्राधान्य इट शुड बी ट्रीटेड फर्स्ट इफ देयर आर कोएक्जिस्टेंस ऑफ टू डिसऑर्डर्स आर ओनली तो वी हैव टू डिसाइड दैट व्हिच शुड बी ट्रीटेड फर्स्ट है ना संश्रेष्टान सन्निपातान बुद्धवा लाइक दैट If there is sansrishta sannipat dosh, to which should be considered first? You know, there is some general in line of treatment that if there is coexistence of some prapti, then it should be treated first. And there are some exceptions like apa jor, you can say that where Achar says that if there is vitiation of three dose, then pith should be treated first most likely. So in the stage of sannipat, you have seen there are many types of sannipata jwar, vatol lavan. So there is sannipat, but there is vatol lavan. There is vat is increased. So we are not considering that which property of vat is vitiated. We are considering that among these three dose, vat is dominant. So we have to consider line of treatment considering vato lavan stage in mind too. We will not consider initially for cough because it is on the later part. So when we consider that in the stage of sansarg or sannipat, which of either dose is on upper hand, so we have to subside that, we have to treat that particular dose, that is known as pradhanya samprapti. And in all these factors we have seen that we are considering the stage of particular dose in vidhi samprapti too. We have considered stage in pradhanya samprapti, we have considered which have predominancy, and we in Vikalp we considered that which particular property of dose is vitiated. So in these contexts we have never considered about what are the Nidan stage of Nidan, what is the stage of symptoms. So when we see that what is the extent of presence of Nidan, Bal, Nidan, Purroop, Roop, and we decide that whether it is easy to treat or not, that samprapti is known as Bal samprapti. आचार्य सेज हे त्वादि कात्सन्यात वह बलाबल विशेषण, बलाबल विशेषण, देन व्हेन वी कंसीडर दैट व्हाट इज द बल ऑफ निदान, व्हाट इज द बल ऑफ पूर रूप, व्हाट हाउ मेनी सिम्टम्स हैव अपीयर्ड इन द स्टेज ऑफ पूर रूप, बिकॉज ईच ऑफ देम हैव इट्स ओन इम्पॉर्टेंस. व्हाट इन द कंटेस्ट ऑफ प्रमेय यू कैन सी दैट देयर इज इन चरक निदान स्थान व्हाट आचार्य सेज दैट एकल निदान दोष दोष विशेषभ्यो विकार विघात भाव अभाव, विकार विघात भाव अभाव प्रति विशेषा भवंती. सो व्हाट सेज दैट द डिग्री ऑफ वॉइशिएशन ऑफ दोष एंड दोष डिपेंडिंग ऑन द डिग्री ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ निदान लीड्स टू विकार विघात भाव दैट काजेस ओरिजिन ऑफ पार्टिकुलर डिजीज एंड दैट मे नॉट काज द ओरिजिन ऑफ दैट डिजीज. देयर आर टू स्टेजेस डिपेंडिंग ऑन द ईच ऑफ दिस. से दैट देयर इज निदान इज ऑफ वेरी अल्प क्वालिटी, है ना. आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग सिंपल एग्जाम्पल ऑफ बल संप्राप्ति दैट इफ समवन गेट्स ट्रामा फ्रॉम सम फॉलिंग फ्रॉम एनी सरफेस व्हेन द डिग्री ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस डिग्री ऑफ ट्रामा इज वेरी लेसर देन इट डज नॉट काजेस एनी सिम्टम. एंड इफ द डिग्री ऑफ trauma is of higher level then it may cause laceration, it may cause wound, it may cause fracture. So that depends on the degree of nidan. If nidan is of having great vitiation and it has great strength then it causes higher number of symptoms that leads to complicated disease. And if dosha is not vitiated properly then it is also not able, they are not also able to produce disease also. And considering the poor roop hetwadi means na, to what achar says in the context of sadhyata sadhyata, you can remember that hetva poor rupani rupani alpaniyasya na, say that hetva poor rupani rupani alpaniyasya in those disease where the vitiating factors are lesser in number, you know, they have lesser degree of strength and poor roop have not appeared properly. So these diseases are known as sukshat, you know. This is the common thing that those hit poor roop and they are, if they are of lesser degree then they are easily curable. And there are so many multifactorial disorders, they are very hard to treat because they have multifactorial origin, they have different nidans, no? Say 1 2 3 4 5, so it is very tough to treat all of these at a time rather than treating single nidan. So when we consider about nidan, presence of nidan, presence of poor roop, at the you can see there in the context of jwar, if there is poor roop appears totally then it becomes incurable in the stage of poor roop itself. There is no need of manifestation. To if there is three poor roop, say that their disease produces three of poor roop. And if all three appears at a time, then it becomes almost incurable. And if one appears at a time, and then it is very easy to cure. So when we consider about nidan, dosh, dosh, how much they are vitiated, then we apply for bal samprapti. Now it's a very last one is kal samprapti. Now we have decided that which dose is vitiated, their degrees, how much vitiation is there in the degree. And now when we consider about the seasonal variation, diurnal variation, that in daytime which dose is is vitiated and in which time, which season dose is vitiated, that samprapti is known as kal samprapti. Kal is having different definitions. So that kind of samprapti, where we see that naktam din dinar bhuktanam bhuktansh vyadhir kalo yathamalam. So when there is consideration of these things, what Acharya says that says punar vyadhin nam ritu ahoratra ahar, punar vyadhir nam ritu ahoratra kal vid vin ahar kal vid vinyeto bhotyat. Acharya Charak says that there is to vyahora, very easy to understand. You must have remembered that what Acharya Bhagavat says, that vayo ahoratri bhuktanam teyant madhyadika kramat. You know, there is vitiation of that particular dose on different specific times of day or specific ritu, and specific there is kal. So that causes some specific symptoms. Said kal samprapti, na, what says that jorin prakrit kal is sukh sadhya and vaikrit kal it is kast sadhya. So we are considering the seasonal variation. Na, jor prakrit is sukh sadhya except vata in varsha, and others all which appears in other than kal, other than their prakop kal, they are uncurable, they are hard to cure. So when we are considering that particular ritu, so we can say that it's kind of kal samprapti. When we consider that kind of age, that which disease appears mostly in which age, so we can say that we are considering the kal samprapti. And if we consider that which disease is curable in which age, that is also kal samprapti. Na? You can see there in the context of grahani, balke grahani sadhya, yoni krichya samirita, vriddhetva asadhya. So we are considering particular age, that balke grahani sadhya, it is very easily curable in the balyavastha. Yoni krichya samirita, it is hard to cure in young stage. That we are considering the age of that particular person, at that particular patient. So in the healing itself, in the fracture of bone, Acharya have said that it takes 1 month, 2 months or 3 months, depending on the age of that particular patient. So we are making prognosis and we are thinking that it is the prognosis of this disease as per their age. So when we consider such kind of thing, that is known as kal samprapti, but it is related with kal, particular time. It is related with particular time. So it is known as kal samprapti. So this is all about samprapti. We discussed that if there is simply counting, then it is sankhya samprapti. When there is internal classification, that is known as vidhi samprapti. And when characteristic of particular person or particular dose is considered, this is known as vikalp samprapti. And when we consider about tartam avastha of different dose in the stage of sansarg and sannipat, not in the stage of ekeksa, that is known as pradhanya samprapti. And when we consider about particular age, particular time, that is kal samprapti. And when we consider about the existence of nidan, when we consider about the nidan and dosha and sotas, likewise, now how many symptoms appear in the stage of purup, how many symptoms appear in the stage of rup, and what are the complications of that disease, how many complications are there, when we consider about this, so that is known as बल संप्राप्ति। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट संप्राप्ति। वी डिड कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड विद संप्राप्ति इन टू लेक्चर्स एंड वी डिस्कस्ड द नॉर्मल संप्राप्ति यथा दोषेण दुष्टेण यथा चान विषय पिता निवृत्तिरामस्य आशो संप्राप्तिर जाति आर्ति नो संप्राप्ति एंड जाति आर सिनोनिम्स दैट व्हाट इज संप्राप्ति सम्यक प्राप्ति इन इजी लैंग्वेज सम्यक प्राप्ति व्हाट इज आगति आगति समन्तात् व्हाट इज जन जाति इट जनि प्रादुर्भाव एंड देन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द जनरल संप्राप्ति व्हिच डायरेक्टली रिफर्स टू क्रियाकाल एंड देन देयर आर when we consider different thing under the heading of samprapti that is known as visist samprapti we consider the number we consider the classification we consider the internal classification we consider the particular property and we consider the specific time so that all constitute the samprapti and they require different line of treatment accordingly so we started this topic that samprapti vightanam yo hi chikitsa samprapti vightan hi chikitsa so if you don't know that which samprapti is applicable and what is the importance of that particular samprapti it is very hard to cure a disease without learning these all thank you all